गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, आई पूर्णिमा वेलकम यू टू माई क्लास। एंड टूडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी ए न्यू लेसन इन द किंगडम ऑफ फूल्स। दिस इज ए कन्नड़ फोक टेल। इन द किंगडम ऑफ फूल दिस इज ए कन्नड़ फोक टेल। द स्टोरी इज ए कन्नड़ फोक टेल। फोक टेल्स आर ऑलवेज फुल ऑफ विजडम। द बुक्स फोक टेल्स फ्रॉम इंडिया by A.K. Ramanujam and classic folk tale from around the world by Robert Nye support this idea. In the Kingdom of Fool, the author tried to show that fools are so dangerous that only very wise people can set them right. In this story, fools have a strange system of administration and way of judgment. It is only the wise guru who brings their kingdom into state of normalcy. It is believed that fools are so dangerous that only very wise people can manage them. Who are the fools in this story? What happens to them? This I will be going to tell you in this story. So, first of all, children, I will be telling you about children. About the background of the story, some important points, and then we will, in detail, I will be doing the explanation of the story. So, my first point is, visiting the kingdom of fools. Visiting the kingdom of fools. Okay, so this is my first point, visiting the kingdom of fools. Now, in this kingdom of fools, both the king and the ministers were foolish. Under their rule, people worked at night and enjoyed sleep at day time. Everything costs the same, a single dudu. Dudu is the currency of that kingdom of fools. So, in the kingdom of fools, there was a king and the minister. And what did they decide? That everybody will sleep during the day and they will work at night. And they also, children, they told that under their rule, people will work 12 hours at night and enjoyed sleep during the daytime. Also, everything will cost the same, that is a single dudu. No matters what and how much of its people bought. Suppose if you will bring a banana, one dozen of banana, that will also cost one dudu. And if you will buy 5 dozen of banana, that will also cost one dudu. So this was the rule. Some were happy, some were not happy, but there was a fear in the mind of the people. If they will not obey the king's law, they will be killed. So, anyhow, deliberately, they have to manage with the wordings of the king. They have to obey the law which was already declared by the king. Now, once a guru and his disciple came to the kingdom. So one day what happened, a guru who does not belong to that kingdom of fools, he came with his disciple into the kingdom of fools. When guru came to know, he saw everybody was sleeping during the day. Not even a single people moved out of the market. All the markets were closed. And at night everybody woke and started doing their work. And not only that, when they went to buy something, they realized everything cost here is one dudu. So, children, it was always this. So, the guru felt that it is not a good place. He asked the people that why you people are doing that, and everybody replied that it is the order given by the king. And if we will not obey the order, we might be killed. The guru made up his mind to leave it. As to him, it was always dangerous to stay among them. However, the disciple felt this place is a cheap one and could eat whatever and how much he wanted by paying only 1 rupee. So it was Guru who decided that he would leave the place. But it was disciple who decided that this is the best place, because whatever he would buy, how much he would buy, it would only cost him only 1 rupee. So he told Guru that he is going to stay there. Guru told him this is not the good place, one day you will fall into trouble. But he did not listen. He told Guru, this is the best place for me to leave. And then children, he started leaving their disciple. And Guru, he left the kingdom, he left the place of the king. Now student, so both Guru and disciple were there in the kingdom, and it was Guru who decided that he would leave the place, and it was Guru who decided to leave the place. And disciple, he thought it is benefit to leave there, because everything cost here 1 rupee, so he thought he would be staying there. Now my second point, theft in the house. Theft means to steal something. So one day children, theft was there in one of the house. One day a thief broke into a house, he stole the thing, and while he was returning, the wall fell upon him and he died. Now the thief brother went to the king and blamed the vault owner for the weakness of the wall. The king called the merchant who was the owner of the house and charged him of this crime. But the owner blamed the bricklayer. He told, the bricklayer has made the wall weak, and that was the reason the wall had fallen down. The bricklayer blamed the bricklayer was called, and then he blamed the dancing girl. He told him, but just because of that girl who danced, just because of her, the condition has become, of his mind has become very poor, and his mind was drawn towards her, and that was the reason, children, the wall fell down. Well, my third point is calling of the dancing girl and the other. Okay, calling of the dancing girl and the other. Well children, the dancing girl was called. The king sent for the dancing girl, who transferred the blame to the goldsmith who did not deliver the ornaments on the given time. And she blamed the goldsmith. She told that just because of goldsmith, I have to go from this place many times, and that's why it may diverted the children, the attention of the bricklayer, and this must have has happened. Finally, and she also told the goldsmith who did not deliver the ornaments on the given time, and made her wait outside where the wall was being made, and that's why she used to stand for many hours, and this happened just due to that. And now the king called the goldsmith, and finally children, who was called? Goldsmith was called. The goldsmith pleaded that he was making merchant's jewelry because of his wedding date drawing near, so he could not deliver the dancing girl ornament. He was asked, why you made dancing girl wait? So he told the king that he had already, he was making a merchant's jewelry, so he had to wait outside. And I told the girl that she has to wait for some time, because right now he is making the ornaments for the merchant whose wedding was very much near. Okay. And so he could not deliver the dancing girl ornament in time. Now the merchant was the same merchant whose wall had fallen down. But he explained that the incident had occurred in his father's time who had died. So he told ki, I am not the same merchant to whom you are thinking. This merchant actually was his father and now he hit dead. He is no more. Preparing a steak. Now children, preparing a steak. So the king told that the culprit has to be punished and he ordered everybody to prepare, the person who is to prepare the steak. Okay, he told him that they have to prepare the steak. So the steak should be closed. So the case, he told, is closed now. And the punishment will be given. And he told on the order, he gave the orders to the person who prepared steak. Okay. But the king told him that as he inherited the property of the father, as the sin, and so miss, he must also inherit the sin of his father. And in place of his father, he would be executed in his deceased father's place. So a steak was prepared for him. However, the merchant's neck was thin. It could not fit in the steak. The king ordered a thick-necked person to be found for execution. Now, since again here king is making a foolish decision, since the merchant neck was not, it was thin. Okay, so he needed a thick person whose neck will prepare in the steak. He ordered the person whose neck would be thin would be caught and he would be brought in front of the king. He would be executed and the soldiers started obeying king's order. They started moving everywhere to find the person whose neck was thin and who will be executed now. So the king ordered a thick-necked person to be found for execution. Well children, the disciple was just coming. The soldiers, they found his neck was thick and therefore children, he was caught for the purpose. He had grown a thick neck by eating to his fill. Now children, why did that disciple of the guru stayed there? Because now children, he had become very fat. He was very happy that here everything cost 1 dudo. He told his people also, his father also, his guru also, sorry, that he would be staying there because everything cost 1 dudo. The guru told him not to stay there as this is the kingdom of fool, but he did not listen. The guru told him that if one day you will fall into trouble because this is not a good place for a wise man to live, but he did not listen. He was so happy. He thought that everything here is costing 1 dudo. So this is the right place for him to stay. And finally, what happened, student? He stayed there. He ate a lot of things every day. And finally, he became very fat. Now he was the person with a thick name and thick neck. So he was caught by the soldiers of the king. He was pushed into the jail and he was told that next day he would be executed because his neck was thick. And this is the order of a king, that whose neck is thick, that person shall be executed. Anxiety of the disciple. My next point is, Anxiety of the disciple. You can see here, anxiety of the disciple. So this is my next point. Okay, now the disciple being in trouble, he closed his eye and he was very sad. He started remembering his guru. He started telling that this is the, if I would have listened to my guru, so this day I would not have seen. Now I'm really in trouble. Next day I would be, very soon or next day I would be executed, I would be killed. Okay, so he was feeling very guilty conscious that why he did not listen to his guru. And the guru, then suddenly when he closed his eye and he realized he was remembering his guru, suddenly he heard, listen in his thought, that as if his guru is telling that very soon I am going to come and save you. Well, very soon his guru arrived also. He asked the king to execute him first and his disciple afterward. Well, he went to the king. The guru started thinking of an idea and he went to the king. He told the king that, see, he told king that you have ordered a thief person to be executed, but this is my request to you that you should execute me first and then you can afterward you can kill him, you can put him to the stake so that he would be killed. Well, he again asked the king to execute him first and his disciple afterward. When the king asked the reason, he told king, no, this is not fair. He would be the person who was chosen to be to be put on the stake. So why he is asking? The king asked so many times and he got the reason. Guru told, okay, I will tell you in your ear and the secret behind it. So he told the reason. He told he would become king and his disciple a minister in the next birth year. The foolish king now decided to die first and his minister afterward. Now he told, this is the stake and for the first time somebody is going to die in this stake. So as per the rule, he told that this stake, this stake is so lucky that if the person who will die first, okay, that he would become a king, and the person who will die second there, he would become a minister in the next birth. Well, when the king heard, he decided, no, this is, I would die there. So in the next birth also, I would become the king. Well, the foolish king now desired to die first and his minister afterwards. Well, finally, he called the persons from the jail. He told that the time of the for putting the people at a stake is changed, and when the first people will enter, you don't have to ask, you don't have to question him anything, you only have to put him into the stake. So secretly the order for killing the disciple was now cancelled, the order to kill the disciple. At night, the person who was guarding the jail, the security guard, he saw two persons were there. Okay, their face was covered. He thought that this is the disciple. Well, he executed them, but actually, it was the king who came for the execution, because he heard that it was Guru. What did he hear? He heard that it was Guru who is going to, he did not want anybody to be king in the next birth also. So he decided that he would die in the stake first. So finally, the foolish king and his minister, they died. So they died, and new king and minister. Now children, the new king and children, finally what happened, children? He released the guru and the disciple king, okay, from the jail, but he and his minister got themselves executed before the guru and the disciple could succeed. The people of the kingdom of fools saw the dead bodies of the king and the minister. They caught the guru and the disciple and made them the king and the minister. Now the new king and the minister changed all laws. People worked during daytime, enjoyed sleep at night. The do-do system of payment was also done away with it. So children, this is was an interesting story. There, how the this teaches us the moral that children, we should be in the company of a wise person. If we will live in the company of a foolish person, we will always fall into trouble. So now children, I have told you the background of the story, okay, and now I will be reading and children telling you the explanation of the story, and then I will also tell you about the new word meaning. So let's start. So children, open to page number 18 of your book Moment, and we are going to do chapter 4 in the Kingdom of Fools. So it is believed that the fools are so dangerous that only very wise people can manage them. Who are the fools in this story? What happens to them? So now I will be doing the explanation, children. In the Kingdom of Fools, both the king and the minister were idiots. They did not want to run things like other kings, so they decided to change night into day and day into night. They ordered that everyone should be awake at night, till their fields and run their business only after dark, and go to bed as soon as the sun came up. Anybody who disobeyed would be punished with death. The people did as they were told for fear of death. Now the explanation part of the story. So children, once upon a time, a kingdom of fool was there, and there, children, the king and the ministers were idiots. They were foolish people. They did not want to run things like other king. They thought they would be doing something other, which generally the king doesn't do. And children, they took a decision. They decided to change night into day. So what was their decision? They decided to change night into day and day into night. They ordered that everyone should be awake at night. So what did they order? They ordered that everybody should awake at night till their fields and run their business only after dark. And children, whether it is their field, okay, the farmers, they work in field, or children, business people, they run their business. All the offices and school, everything they will be opening in the dark at night, and they will go to bed as soon as the sun will be there. Anyone who disobeyed would be punished with death. So he told, anybody who would be disobeyed, they would be punished with death. The people did as they were told for fear of death. The king and the minister were delighted at the success of their project. Now children, everybody has to obey it. Because children, they were very much, they had a fear of death. The king and the minister were delighted at the success of their project. One day a guru and his disciple arrived in the city. It was a beautiful city. So children, what happened? The guru and the disciple, they came to the city. It was a beautiful city. It was broad daylight, but there was no one about. Now children, the whole city looked very beautiful, but it was broad daylight, and children, everybody was sleeping. They were a bit surprised that at this time of day light, why everybody is not outside, why everybody is inside sleeping. Everyone was asleep, not a mouse stirring. Even the cattle had been taught to sleep by day. So children, even the cattle, it slept by day. Well, the two strangers were amazed. Okay, so children, the two strangers, they were very much amazed. Amazed means surprised. So all the people, children, they were very much surprised. And children, by what they saw around them, they wandered around town till evening. So children, what happened? They wandered. Wander means to roam here and there, to move here and there. So these people, they wandered around, okay, and till evening, where suddenly the whole town woke up and went about its nightly business. And children, the night was there, the whole town woke up, and now children, they started doing their nightly business. Well, these two people were very much surprised. They told, what type of city is this? They slept during the day and they are working at night. Okay. The two men were hungry. Now the shop were open. Now children, in the daytime the shop were not open. Now the shop were also opened. They went to buy some groceries. Now children, they went to buy some groceries. What is grocery? Children, whatever eatables item is there. Okay, we buy from the shop, that is groceries. To their astonishment, they found that everything cost the same, a single dodo. So children, when they went there, they thought that everything cost the same, the single dodo, whether they bought a measure of rice or a bunch of banana. So children, whether they bought a measure of rice or a bunch of banana, children, everything cost one dodo. The guru and his disciple were delighted. They had never heard of anything like that. So children, in all the city, the fruits were very costly. The dry fruits were much costlier. But this was a city where everything cost only one dodo. So they were very happy, both the guru and the disciple. Delighted. Delighted means they were delighted. So both guru and children, the disciple, they were very much happy. They were delighted. They could buy all the food they wanted for a rupee. They have never heard of anything like this. They could buy all the food they wanted for a rupee. So for one dodo, it was equivalent to 1 rupee. They could buy anything. So children, they were very, very happy. For the first time, children, they have seen the place like that. When they had cooked and eaten, the guru realized that this was a kingdom of fools and it would not be a good idea for them to stay there. Now children, the guru had eaten the food, and finally children, he realized after eating that this was a kingdom of fools. He started thinking that the days here children, the people sleep during day and in night, they do everything, the cost of everything is saved at one dodo. So he realized finally that this was a kingdom of fools and it would not be a good idea for them to stay there. This is no place for us, let's go, he said to his disciple. Now he told his disciple that this is not a good place for us and let's move from here. But the disciple did not want to leave the place because everything was cheap here. All he wanted was good cheap food. So children, the disciple decided that he would not move from there because everything was so cheap there and he wanted to have a good cheap food. So finally he told Guru that he would not move from here. Well children, now children, the time is over, and with the time children, I will be telling the story, the other part of the story in my next video. So I conclude my video here. Thank you and have a nice day ahead. Bye bye.